He's got $143 worth of stuff, offering $100. He's got the camera bags. He's got two bags down here.
I see a lot of vintage stuff. You have like an antique booth or something?
I sell on eBay.
Do you?
Yeah. I just got too much and I just want to clear some of it out.
I know the feeling. Are you selling any Apple products or just all the boxes?
Just the boxes. Which I thought was weird, but I guess people buy them.
How much are the boxes?
Do a couple bucks on each.
Couple bucks a piece. How much is your truck?
Somebody else just asked me that. I don't know. I'd probably take 25 for it.
Okay.
Because it's not in that great a shape. But I just put new windows in it.
Which car is yours? How are you doing?
I'm doing well. How are you?
Doing good. Are you able to work with me on price on if I buy a lot of stuff?
I'm sorry?
Are you able to work with me on price on if I buy a lot of stuff?
What do we got here?
I've got a couple backpacks so far. I'm still shopping.
Okay.
Video games.
Let me put it over by the stove.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Here. We'll do that. You brought the IKEA bag?
Yeah, I can't prepare.
Very smart. Very smart.
Oh, here. This sticker came off. Let me put that back on there.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Uh-huh. Thank you.
Okay, I found some more stuff.
All right.
There's $5 for these. There's 3 and 2 on it.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
3 and 2.
I got you. I trust you. Thank you. All right. So with the Switch, or with, because it has 4 games in it, or I mean the Nintendo, he's got 75 on that. So I called and asked him. So let me mark that before I forget here, just in case you change your mind.
Okay.
Good morning.
Good morning.
See, I called him and he said 20 on the games because there's all of those games in there.
Okay.
So you want to think about that one or you want that?
I think I'm going to pass on this one.
Okay.
This was 20. I think it's on top there.
Yep. Okay. So 24.
Couldn't find a price on that one.
We'll put 5 on that one.
Okay, so 29.
Yep. That'd be... Okay. So you're at 98 right now.
Counting this or not?
No.
So.
You got 15 on each one of those. You got 30 on that, 35,
39, 30 on, wait, so back up just a second.
60.
These two 15 are 30.
Yeah.
And this is 20, so that's 50.
Right.
54, 55.
Yeah.
You said 5, that's 60.
Yeah.
So 62, 63.
Yeah, and then how much is that? One. And this was, he put 5 on that.
So. Okay, so 68?
Yeah, 68.
Okay.
Said
that's okay. 75 would be 143. I do 100 bucks for everything.
Justin, this is mainly your stuff. He's got $143 worth of stuff, offering $100. He's got the camera bags. He's got 2 bags down here.
No.
Okay.
You split it at $120?
No. No, I know. Those are priced appropriately.
Give it to you, give it to him.
This is all his, so he can get it, yeah. You want it? Okay. So you go ahead and give it to me.
Thank you.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Sorry.
Oh, there you go.
You want to put the game in there? It'll probably fit in there for you. Think you got it all?
I think I got it. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Have a good day.
You too.
Bye. Okay. You're back.
How much are the phones?
The $5 each.
You got 2 big boxes of these. What would you do if I bought all of them?
Make me an offer.
How about 50 bucks?
I'll take it.
All right, thank you.
I agree.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
I'll leave them there if that's okay. I don't keep looking around.
Yes, it's fine.
How much are these?
They are, the large ones are $10 and the small ones are
$5.
Oh, that's okay. They're flying around. Yeah, we don't know what we got
missing. After the storm, we're missing signs. We don't know what we have signs on it.
Do you guys clean out an office or something?
Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry.
How much are the label printers?
Sorry, some kid did that.
No, it's okay.
The label printer, where is that?
This one, I don't know if it's got a thing or not.
Yeah, it should. And we have another one. Hey, John. Oh, here it is. Okay. Oh, here we go. This is, we have a, that is the label printer. We have this mixed up. I don't think my husband knew. These are the labels in these boxes here. And then that's a UPS label printer.
Okay.
You want that.
How much for all this stuff?
I'm going to say 40 bucks for all that.
Do you have the charger for this one, you know? I was looking everywhere and couldn't see it.
Let me ask my husband because he organized some of this.
Okay.
There's one somewhere. If not, I'll just throw it in for free and you might be able to order one.
Okay.
Where it was in here? Is that
it was
what
in
it was?
Here, yeah, and I'm looking. I see a lot of swing lines.
God, I can't believe I did this. These are all swing lines.
How about 30 and then I can just buy an adapter online?
Sold.
All right, thank you, ma'am. Okay. Thank you.
And this,
I'll add that over there.
You sound like you're interested in office stuff.
Yeah.
That is a letter folder.
Oh, wow.
So it's actually very cool. It's not, you can't see it well, but you set, that's the bottom. You set it up on a tabletop. This catches the envelopes. Or not catches the envelopes, catches the folded paper.
Okay.
So you feed paper in it, and it folds it in thirds, getting it ready for an envelope.
Wow. Okay, I'll take a look.
So it's a neat thing.
Excuse me, ma'am.
What's
What's up, John?
Hey, man. How's it going?
I met you at the Xenia grad sale. I'm Vincent.
Yeah, that's what, like 3 or 4 months ago? I remember that. You got a bunch of Disney stuff, right?
Yeah, I didn't do so hot on that, though.
Oh, man. I'm sorry.
It's all right. How are you doing today?
Doing really good. I just came from Birch Bark.
Birch Bark?
It was like 10 minutes from here. They had a bunch of stuff.
Gotcha.
Yeah, they like would not budge on prices, but they had some good stuff.
Yeah. I haven't been doing too hot. I've been to like 3 or 4 of them, and I don't know, just haven't been finding stuff, I guess.
Oh, that's too bad, man. I'm sorry. Just keep at it. You'll find stuff.
For sure. Yeah. This looks like an office clean out or something.
So. Yeah, I just bought the 2 boxes of phones and labels and other stuff. Yeah.
Awesome. All right, good luck, man.
Hey, good luck to you, man. Take care. Would you guys consider selling any of these carts?
Yeah, they're for sale.
What are you asking for them?
That's a good question. Let me ask my wife.
Okay.
I think they were 50, but I'm not sure. Black was sold, but this one and the smaller.
Sorry. Steps down here. You said the black one sold?
The black one sold. Okay. Yeah, we had 50 carts.
I'll take it. There you go.
Awesome.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.
Good luck with the sale.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
Morning.
$2 for that. Hi.
Glad you were here to answer that question.
Okay, you have a good day.
Oh, Jen, you know, you want the stuff on top of this bedding, like bed stuff?
What? Somebody wants them to get them out and clean them off until we sell some stuff on top.
Yeah, I found a couple things.
Cool.
I've got 2 screwdrivers for $1 each.
Okay.
This is $1.50, so it's $3.50. And I didn't see a price on these two.
Okay.
That's an adapter. $2 on this one.
Okay.
And this, we'll do $1.
All right, $6.50.
There you go.
There you go. Thank you,
ma'am. Thank you so much. You have a great day.
You
Thanks
too.
For your support.
Open back in there, what it is. I
Those are easy eBay. They're super popular right now because of the stay-at-home stuff. Everybody was doing Nintendo Switches. She sold her unit for like
with a only a couple games for
$300. It's like the thing to do.
You know, that'd look great in your garage.
It would. It absolutely would. For $12.
Right, $12. I can wait till she's done.
Actually,
I'm not in any hurry.
You have to ask him and the weirdo in the hat.
Okay.
Thank you.
She told me to ask you for prices on this stuff.
Okay. Oh, $3, $5, $10, $10, 13. This is a funny putter.
Yeah, it's goofy.
The woodsy. It actually has a prism in it. $10.
For the putter?
Yeah.
And then how about the thing?
$10.
How about $20 for everything? You do that?
$25.
All right, let's do it.
That's from The Office, this guy.
Yeah, Dwight.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's hilarious. There you go. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Have a good day. How you doing?
Good choices.
I'm gonna get that for three. I was wondering if you do three for that as well.
No. So you're saying you wanna pay six for both?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, thank you. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
I just got back from the garage sales, and today was like the first day of the whole year I've really been able to go out and actually go garage selling. I've went to two garage sales the whole year before today, but today did not disappoint. I'm going to show you guys what I got.
All right, it's kind of scattered all over the warehouse, but I'll start right here.
This is a Manfrotto tripod. I've sold a handful of these over the years and done really well. If you guys have never heard of that brand, Manfrotto, definitely look out for it. They sell for good money. This one, I paid $20 for it, and I should get around $100. This right here is a vintage pot. Doesn't really look like anything special, but it is Magnolite. I just recently learned about this brand, and they seem to do pretty good. I picked up this Christopher Radko clown ornament. They were asking $5, but I got it for $3. And at that same sale, I got this blanket. It's not a San Marcos or anything crazy like that, but it does have a little bit of value. It is Goodwin Weavers. I think it's like a sun and moon pattern, but I paid $3 for that. Should sell 30 or 40 at least, I think. And then here's some small odds and ends I got at one sale. A couple of screwdrivers, those are just for myself to use. Casio calculator, I don't think it's super valuable, maybe $15, but I think I only paid $1 for it. I think this was $1 or $2. It is a VHS cassette adapter. It would usually bring about $20. And I almost missed this. I found this after going through this stuff again. This is an Olympus voice recorder, digital voice recorder. I paid $2 for it, and I've done really well selling these. It seems like Sony and Olympus are really good ones to pick up if you can find them. I did not look this up yet, but I'm sure it's worth $20-$30, something like that. All right, this cart is loaded with stuff, and I actually bought the cart too. This is at that sale where they were clearing out an office, just getting rid of a bunch of stuff, and they were selling the carts too, which is really rare that I see places selling nice carts like this. This is a Rubbermaid commercial grade. I paid $50 for this. Then they had a huge box of staplers. I actually found a Dymo label printer in here and pulled it out and bought it with some other stuff. And then once I went back around and looked up these staplers, I realized that they had some pretty good value too. They are, what is it? There's the brands on here somewhere, I know. EH70F electronic stapler, max flat clinch. Can't remember, Maxco, I guess is the name of the company. I got this whole box and some labels for like $20, and these are definitely gonna bring some good money. Here's a couple of the boxes of the labels that I got. These are inkjet labels. Let's see, color bar print, 1,000 labels in each thing. I did not look at the barcode, but I know labels have some decent value, and they're all sealed in the plastic, so I thought I'd do okay. This is a really cool print. Looks like you got the Capitol building there, some airplanes, American flag. The guy was wanting $10 for it, but I ended up bundling it with some other things he had and paid $25 for everything, so I've probably got $6 or $7 into it. I think this is going to go in my antique booth. And then down here, a couple of these things I got at the one sale where the guy did not want to negotiate, like, at all. I was... I was trying to get a discount, but he wasn't going for it. But that's all right. There's still money to be made. I got two of these backpacks. The brand is Peak Design. I've never heard of it, but I looked up Peak Design, and it seems like these are selling for really good money. I think they might be for photography. Just the way that these dividers are, I think this is probably set up for some kind of, you know, camera rig or something. Everyday backpack, 20 liters. But yeah, they're in good shape. They're 15 bucks a piece. There's another one somewhere else. And then he had this little Peak Design range pouch for 4 bucks. Looks like, yeah, it's for a lens. And I scanned the barcode, and this is going for 30, 40 bucks. This is a game I got for my daughter. Got a couple of bobbleheads at one sale. This is Dwight Schrute. I'm just going to be keeping him. And here is Mateen Cleaves. Played at Michigan State. I guess he played for Detroit. I don't really remember much of his NBA career. A couple more things I picked up at that sale. I got the Nintendo 3DS. It has the charger. And I think the values of these have gone way up since the pandemic started. More and more people were playing video games. I only thought these were worth about 75 bucks, but I saw some sold comps around like 150. And he's got 3 Zelda games and a Mario Kart too. So I think there's some money to be made on that. Got another little voice recorder. This one's not digital. It uses a tape, but for 2 bucks, it's hard to go wrong. Probably worth 25 bucks or so. I saw this and I seem to remember selling something similar. This is Ham, the character from Toy Story, and this is, I think, from like Toy Story 2 or Toy Story 3, where, like, you know, the kid's using his imagination and he turns into some kind of airplane, and I think he might have some value. Could be wrong, but for $1.50, I thought it was worth a chance. Before I forget, let me move this box and show you guys what's in this one underneath. So I got 2 big boxes of these Yalink, I guess that's how it's pronounced, Y-E-A Link. They are all HD telephones, and I typically don't mess with this kind of stuff, but it seemed like it was higher end, and I looked up the model, and it seems like they're going for about $30 each plus shipping, and I got 2 big boxes like this for 50 bucks. I think each box has 1, 2, 3, maybe like 6 or 7 of them. Got this walleye board. I guess this just measures walleyes. I think I paid $3 for it as part of a bundle deal, and I think I saw the comps around 20 bucks or so. Picked up this putter in that same bundle deal, and it caught my eye because it's made of acrylic, and I have seen a lot of putters over the years because I specialize in sporting goods, and I've never seen this. So I went ahead and picked it up, didn't look it up at the time, but I did just recently look it up, and I think it's worth about 25 bucks. All right, here is the other Peak Design bag. Sorry, my neighbors are being incredibly loud at the lawnmowers today. I also paid 15 bucks for this one. It is, glad it might have the model number on there. But yeah, it's also in pretty good shape. And these are the dividers. So like, I think these would be for like a camera body and a lens, but they're pretty nice. Here's another bag from that sale. This is not the Peak Design brand, but it looked pretty nice, so I went and picked it up. I think it was like 5 bucks. Here is the other box of telephones. I think there's more in this one than there was in the other one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think there's almost 10 phones in this one. And then right here from that same sale, here's a Dymo label printer. They did not have a power cord. I think I bundled it with this one and some other things and maybe paid like 30 bucks maybe. This is an OKI. I think it also makes 4x6 labels. Let me see. LD630D. Have not looked that one up yet, but seemed to be like a pretty nice one. And then more labels. I just have a ton of these labels, so I'm hoping those do well. I could not be happier with what I found today. I'm expecting to make some really good money on that stuff, and I'm just really excited that garage sales are back. Hey guys, so I was about ready to end the video, but I completely forgot that I need to do some giveaways. In my 2 previous videos, I announced that I was going to give away 3 wholesale lots and also one of the boxes that Jeff sent me, which was just chock full of product. You ready to do a giveaway?
Yes.
Okay.
I want to do a giveaway.
Okay, the first video is right here. So we're going to take that URL and put it into the comment picker. This one has 1,387 comments. It's a lot of comments, isn't it?
Yep.
And we're going to draw for three winners.
Yep.
Darcy's going to press the button.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
For three winners.
Three winners. Okay. It's picking the winner. Look. See all those names?
Mm-hmm.
All right. First winner is F.A. Toilet. And they commented, I'm a winner. You are a winner. Go ahead and send me an email. My email address is cincinnatipicker@gmail.com. I'll put a link down below in the description and send me your address and I will send you your wholesale lot. All right, you want to pick another one?
Mm-hmm.
All right, press here again. Okay, watch. See all those names? Okay, second winner is Rick Morton. Congratulations, great job. I have my hand raised for a wholesale lot. Well, Rick, you win one. So shoot me an email, give me your address, and I will get it out to you.
Let's do it.
All right, one more.
Okay.
You ready to hit enter?
Mm-hmm.
Press it again. All right. Third and final winner of the wholesale lot is Bobby Boxes. Thanks for the selling tips. You are welcome, Bobby, and you just won the wholesale box. So shoot me an email, get me your address, I will get it out to you. All right, let's pull up the other video. It is right here. This one had 1,100 comments.
Uh-huh.
There we go. Okay, now let's get those comments generated. All right, Darcy, you ready to pick another winner? Okay, click the button right here. One winner. One winner for the box of Jeff's stuff. That's good. Yep, you held it down too long. Ryan XO, you won. Awesome video, John. Really appreciate the entertaining content lately. Hope all is well. Stay safe. Hope all is well with you too, Ryan. And shoot me an email. I will get that box out to you. That's it for this video, guys. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.